you don't have worn out gloves.
It's crooked.
Is that worn out? Is your iPod fingers?
These are my special iPod fingers. I paid extra for these gloves. Usually they're available for 99 cents. These ones I spend a little bit more
on. The Apple version?
Yeah, yeah.
I understand the index finger wearing out, but how come the middle finger's wearing out there?
All right. Did you hit it?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's Ben.
All right. Well,
good day.
Come in, Afghanistan. Come in, Afghanistan. Are you with us? This is our special Remembrance Day dispatch. Afghanistan, can we hear you? Hey, we're checking in today from the Japanese War Memorial here at 12 o'clock on 11-11. So we came down for the ceremony, and after doing a little bit of reconnaissance of the beach environment, we returned to check out some of these reefs in general. Of course, Commander Krug has a few new spangles of his own to show off from his notorious service that he's been conducting. Can you explain to us what these accolades are for?
This is from my recent trip to the commune in Beijing, China, an architectural compound. This is my, in commemoration of the huge wild sockeye salmon run we had this year.
Oh,
30
indeed.
Million sockeye salmon returning to the West Coast. And our little downtown east side purple thistle solidarity.
Well, I must say the spangles look striking on you. On a day, that spangles are brought out for everyone to enjoy, yours are particularly enlightening. Now, let's check out the different battles. These are, here in Stanley Park, this is the Japanese War Cenotaph, and each of these things here commemorates a different battle. See, like, one of the most famous Canadian battles here of all time, Passchendaele, Vimy Ridge is right around here. And today we saw a couple of unique things. As former Army cadet, and now the Hawkeye Pierce of our small battalion, Dr. Trauben, will point out.
Looking like you, Bob.
No, he's BJ.
So today we saw kind of a little bit of a hybrid of British and Japanese and West Coast culture.
Yeah, it was very interesting. You know, it made me think about loyalty, right? Like, because you get loyalty to your race, loyalty to your religion, and then loyalty to the ground that you walk upon. And now it's, you know, it's becoming more like a global community where, you know, through internet and these kind of things, we're realizing the global loyalty that we have. And you really see that today. And what hit it home for me today was watching a Japanese elder woman sing God Save the Queen, which was kind of interesting.
Yeah, it was strange, right?
Very strange.
Like but it felt really comfortable and classically West Coast, too. And so then all these different associations and groups of Canadian, Japanese, and related civic organizations each took their turns laying a wreath.
Come check some of these battles out, Lisa. Right here we have August 1917, Hill 70, World War One.
Passchendaele, the movie we watched last year.
Yep, Passchendaele, famous Canadian battle.
Here we have Vimy Ridge,
also 1917.
And I'm curious about this National Nikkei Museum and Heritage Center. Like, is that some place that we can go to and check out Japanese culture?
Have tea.
And the Buddhist, a nice lady from the Buddhist church came and gave a little prayer to her.
This is an interesting one. Mons. Doctor, do you know where the Mons is?
Do you know?
You have to tell me. I have no idea.
It's the pelvic bone ridge on the front.
Oh,
of
the Mons
female.
Pubis.
Yes,
you mean?
Yes,
oh, of
yes.
course.
He is a doctor, and he has personally examined several cases in which he had to investigate that region. All right, on that note, Commander, we're out from the Japanese Cenotaph here on Remembrance Day, giving it up for all the veterans, past and present, and all the people affected by wars in whatever country. And here's to all the people who are just trying to get along on an everyday basis in war-torn climates.
Peace.
There were several lizards, yeah. It was pretty neat. Maybe you want to eat sushi.